keeping Mercedesing. In this video, we're going to be talking about the EHA. If any of my videos helped you repair your car, then please hit the button thanks. If you, yeah, you, want to be the first one to watch my videos as they're fully uploaded, then become a supporter of the channel. And if you want to watch the service manuals, then become a donor. And if you would be kind, please, to support my Patreon, then here is the link to that site. And see you there also. Thanks. Everything you have seen in my videos was under the circumstances that everything was fine. And I mean that no one has been messing up with the cables, where they go and where they're connected, and that they're as they are supposed to be connected. What I want to say is that there is an issue which says difficult cold starts. This indicates usually, let's say it like that, in 90% of all the cases to the OVP. When you have difficult either cold or warm start, then you have something bad concerning the OVP. But if you have difficult cold starts, warm starts, so and so, but cold starts, that can also indicate issues with the EHA. Why is that? This is the EHA. And this is the EHA plug. And as you can see, it goes only one way. You see here this thing, this indentation. It goes just like this. And this is how it looks like when it is connected. Let me show you now something. If you take a closer look, you will see that here says number one and here number two. But now, if you take a closer look, you will see that here it says number one and here number two. So practically, as we connect them, pin number one goes to the plug number two, and pin number two goes to the plug number one. So, as you can see, they go in an X. Because, as you can, like this, connect the plug of the EHA with the EHA itself. You can connect it only one way, just like this. Then there is something strange. And that's not just like that without any reason. And if you swap the places of these two, then you can have this issue. Difficult cold starts. And here, this one is number one. And this one is number two. Number one is usually black, and number two is black-brown. So what does this mean? This means if you swap their places, then as you start the car, or as you try to start the car, when the car is cold, then the ECU is going to be confused. Because instead of making the mixture richer, it's going to make it leaner than it is supposed to be. And you will have a bad or very, very difficult cold start. So always check that number one, black one, is connected to the ECU plug number 12, and number two, which in your case is going to be black brown. These two are identical. They're all both of them are black, and it makes for me no difference, because this is just a testing cable. But always check this. Take your multimeter and with a buzzer check whether when you, as you remove the plug, you put one part of the multimeter into the plug number one, and this one must be connected to the plug on the ECU number 12. So here we have 13, so this is number 12. So there, that's what you have to do. Once again, for all of you who have 25 contacts. And number two must be beeping with number 10 on the ECU plug. 13, 12, 11, 10. There. As for all of you who have ECU 5, the ECU with 55 contacts, then here they're labeled as positive and negative. So your positive, which is usually number one here on the plug, has to be connected to the contact number 37. And the negative has to be connected to the contact number 55, to the last one. So, if you liked this video,
please consider subscribing to our YouTube channel and click the bell to be notified when we post new videos.
Then I would kindly ask you not to hit the button skip ad. That is going to help me a lot. And till some next one, hyper Mercedes-ing. Bye.